you are. You're just in time. I'm trying out a few recipes for my new Betty Crocker cookbook. I hope you like shish kebab. Damn, it isn't ready yet. Bob's still moving. Tonight's foul feast will begin with mashed potatoes, then move on to some shrieking duck, and finish with a nice kielbasa. I call this tasty tidbit morning mess.
Some fresh bed sheets. Evening edition.
Shit. Look at that.
Oh, fuck the hooch, man. I'm taking you to a hospital.
I hate fucking hospital. I've got too many good rounds left in me yet.
Fucking dancer. You're going down for the count. I'm going for help.
Who's out there? Listen here, I'm a former middleweight.
Fucking battle. Dancer.
Dancer! Dancer!
You gotta leave now.
I thought we were gonna spend the day together.
Well, that was Jack Danner's talking. Dale Sweeney's telling you to cop a broom.
What?
Oh, shit!
You think you can just chew women up at night and...
Baby, in my line of work, you don't have time for long meals.
Keep your paws off of me! You make me sick!
You motherfucker! Fuck you! You could be living in a mobile home, but you have no class, you idiot!
None of the problems which plague our society can be fully overcome without the cooperation of private enterprise. I and six of my fellow citizens are here today, not simply because we believe that statement, but also because we share a common past. We were all once homeless, and are homeless no longer. We feel it is time to repay our city for providing us with the opportunity to help ourselves. Therefore, we have banded together to form the Grateful Homeless Outcasts and Unwanted's Layaway Society. The Grateful Homeless Society, for short.
You're late again. I guess the great Dale Sweeney really has lost his touch.
I could lose my eyesight and still run circles around you, Klinsky.
You forget who broke the insurance scandal last month? Friends are starting to call me
school. I didn't know your friends could read.
Hey, Mr. Sweeney, it's here's a number, and I'm on your ass.
Stand your own ass for a while, Putz.
Hey!
So after a lifetime of pain, there will be an eternity of dignity. Now, in keeping with my usual demure nature, I will defer all questions to our society's spokesperson, Ms. Jess Gilchrist.
Excuse me, Ms. Gilchrist?
Thank you, Mr.
Gilchrist. Shouldn't you be spending money above the ground instead of underneath it?
We don't think so.
And why throw money at the dead when you can use it to help the homeless who are living?
That's a good point.
The Grateful Homeless Society feels that there are many existing organizations that currently provide aid to the living. Beacons in the Night, as Mr. Copard liked
to... It's safe to say that there aren't enough of these beacons to keep you from opening up this place.
That is your interpretation of the situation. Yes.
How many members of the society have, anyway?
I only wish that you could be the first recipient of the Grateful Homeless Society's generosity.
They cut my electricity. My alarm did not go off.
Well, maybe you should buy an alcohol-powered generator. That way you could urinate into it every morning and have enough electricity for the whole day.
It's hilarious. Give me a break, Tillman.
No, break isn't exactly the term, Mr. Sweeney. Try severance.
Severance?
Yes. I'm not going to play this crap game with you anymore. Will Sweeney show up, or is he too busy getting his oil changed?
Please, don't do this to me now, please.
All right. How about 5 seconds from now?
Elaine, I mean, come on.
Time's up. You're fired.
Okay, fine. It's no skin off my nose. I'll just go hit up the Herald.
Great. You want a recommendation? I mean, it's a great chance to cripple the competition.
Makes the street look like the fucking White House.
Look, man, I got nothing to give you, man.
You got fingers, you got a hand.
What's the matter? Don't you recognize the homeless killer?
Shit!
I need you to use those fingers and those hands of yours to do a little ink slinging for me. I need you to write an article.
What about?
I ain't no killer. The only thing I am is hard up.
If you're not the killer, then who is?
If I told you what's going on, you'd think I had a kink in my slinky. Tomorrow, they're having their first planting at the Grateful Homeless Cemetery.
Cemetery?
Go there. Hang out till sunset. You'll see. Do it, and I'll spill the rest like a fucking floodgate. I'll even throw in a few names.
Names?
Yeah. City officials with their mitts in the Grateful Homeless. Meet me tomorrow night, 25th in Tivoli.
Wait a minute. Why me?
Because you look hungrier than I do.
Time to keep and a time to cast away. Time to rend and a time to sow. Time to keep silence and a time to speak.
Nice home now.
The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away.
Sometimes he forgets that first part.
That's a pretty jaded view of life.
Well, maybe coming from you. I mean,
The Lord giveth you plenty.
You've taken quite an interest in this place.
I'm just following up a story, looking for anything out of the ordinary.
Well, there's nothing here but the dead. Why not let them rest in peace?
And dignity.
That too.
Hey, look, I hope I didn't rattle you too much the other day.
It takes a lot more than that to rattle me.
Oh, well, I would give anything to find out just what that could be.
Well, stick around. You're working up to it.
I was kind of hoping to buy you lunch.
Now, why would I want to have lunch with you?
Because I'm far more interesting than whatever Gumby you might be seeing right now. And you also might be interested to see the story that I'm writing on that little society of yours. What do you say? Huh? Mm. Love telling stories. Ugh.
You know, I was thinking more along the lines of a nice, quiet restaurant.
Well, this is quiet, and you don't have to leave a tip.
At least not money. So, I thought you were going to tell me a story.
Well, actually, I thought it would be better if we waited until we finished eating.
Why is that?
I lied. It's just a routine notice. Needed the company. You're not going to storm out of here?
You've already killed my afternoon. Besides, it never hurts to improve press relations.
You know, the Grateful Homeless Society is very fortunate to have you for its spokesperson.
Uh-oh. Are we working up to a compliment?
No, it's just that most spokespersons don't have a sense of humor, nor do they look like you.
Now I am rattled.
Sure you don't want a bite?
I don't eat meat.
Oh, God, you're not one of those, are you?
Not exactly. You look good enough to eat.
I've never met anybody like you, boy. You wear me out.
Do you really want to see me again?
Yes, I really would like that. You know, I'm not the type of guy who believes in love at first sight, but I think I'm about to convert. You're the type of girl that I could spend a lifetime with. Hey, let me ask you something. Off the record. What do you think about the Grateful Homeless Society?
Who cares? Off the record.
Wait.
Is this your own private press conference? Is that what this is?
Okay, just go easy with that, will you?
I've just declared a news blackout.
Well, look, you know, I'm only doing my job.
You don't want to see me do mine. So, I'm the kind of girl that you could spend a lifetime with.
All right, just pumping you for information. What the hell? Where that came from?
Roebuck!
I saw was graves. Who the hell did this to you?
You fucking dickhead. You didn't stay long enough.
You're gonna tell me your story. Huh? You're gonna tell me what you know. Names! You were gonna give me names! I need that fucking story, you fucking bum! Don't die on me! Don't fucking die! Oh, come on, you son of a bitch!
Help. Mr. Sweeney, you need burial.
I need an assignment, Tillman.
You must be joking. I'm gonna have to hire somebody to come in and clean up the mess you made just walking in here.
You wanted to see me, Chief?
Wait a minute, wait. You gave my job to this lowlife?
Yeah. I thought it was about time I had a writer doing it. I want you to head out to the Grateful Homeless Cemetery. They're burying that homeless killer there.
Today?
That's right. You better hurry if you want a spot. Now look. I don't want to have to call security. What am I saying? I'd love to call security. Norma, get security up here. Never mind, Norma. Just call a janitor.
And so we commit this soul to eternity.
It was right.
Good evening, Mr. Sweeney.
Nice of you to drop by for dinner.
Who the hell are you people?
Well, that depends. Until recently, we were known as the infamous homeless killer. But now you may refer to us as the Grateful Homeless Outcasts and Unwanted's Layaway Society.
Ghouls?
It's been so long since we've had fresh meat.
Wouldn't you say? I guess in the end, Mr. Sweeney learned not to go digging into other people's business. Although you'll be happy to hear he's found himself a new career. As a ghostwriter. So, still hungry for dessert? I hope you like cannibal soup. It's good.